Hello, this is the Tradesight US stocks and futures market preview for the week beginning Monday, the 29th of December 2014, and ending Friday, the 2nd of January 2015. We are starting the whole new year, do it all over again, as they say. Here's a look at the ES. This is the S&P E-mini front month futures contract on a daily chart. You can see we're working our way towards another 13 sell signal. We are at bar 10. If I go to projection mode here, Friday closes out bar 10 most likely. And the last 13 caused a dip, so we'll see if this next one we would get it maybe in the first week, first full week of January if it keeps going here. Be interesting to see if we can get that, or if we get that recycled. For those who know what that means, the green count is heading towards a new 9-bar startup phase. Either way, nobody was around this week. We had a half day on Wednesday for Christmas Eve. We had a full day on a closed day. Markets were off on Thursday for Christmas. And the market, as usual, on no volume, just drifted higher. You can see the volume data at the bottom of the screen for the futures anyways. Really, really slow all week. So right now, got the S&P closing at the highest close of the year on Friday at 2088.77. That's the S&P cash. We've got the NASDAQ inside the MDX 100, not yet at the highest of the year, but we still have 3 days left where that could happen. Here's a look at the SOX, the semiconductor index, dead flat this week for the couple of days that we had, and not at new highs for the year. Biotech's gained 70 after shaking around earlier in the week. Notice the perfect bounce off that red static trend line after the big down day on Tuesday. Let's take a look at Google. Got a bounce as well, so it's not closing at the low of the year. Apple has not been doing much the last week or two. VIX closed around 1450 for the week after being much higher while we dipped earlier in the month. Crude oil closed at 54.87 for the week. A lot of ramifications for that. And gold bounced a little bit on Friday and basically closed flat for the week. Let's also take a quick look at volume, because this is important. So remember, we only had 4 trading days this week. Monday and Tuesday were between 1.4 and 1.6 billion shares on the NASDAQ, which is light. Not horrible, but light. We got a little bit done those days. But then Wednesday, of course, the half day, Christmas Eve, barely over 600,000 shares. And then you go on to a closed market on Thursday, Friday, 870 million. By the way, if we go back and look at last year real quick, I'll slide this back to December of last year. Now remember, last year Christmas was on a Wednesday. So you had 2 days and then the big down day, under 800,000 shares is Christmas Eve. That's the half day. Christmas Day was a Wednesday. So then you had Thursday, Friday, we're back up between 1.0 and 1.2 billion shares. Now, what I want you to keep in mind about that is the equivalent of that was just the day we just had, Friday. Instead of being 1.1 or 1.2, we were at 880 million shares. So we're way off of last year's pace in terms of these days between the markets. I think the fact that, or the holidays, I think the fact that Christmas was on Thursday makes it a little tougher because nobody comes back just to trade one Friday when in the middle of the holiday season. And then you can see on this from last year, the Monday and Tuesday, the following week, market volume was back up just a bit. And then Wednesday, we were closed for New Year's Day. Then we bounced back for 2 days back near the 1.6 billion share for that Thursday and Friday. And it wasn't until that weekend completed, we came back in and volume jumped back over 2 billion shares. So what do we expect looking now at the next couple of days? Of course, again, since this has been tracking worse, I would say we'd be lucky to get to 1.2 or so on Monday and Tuesday. Wednesday, which is New Year's Eve, is a full day of trading, but nobody's ever around. The rule, New York Stock Exchange rule, is that the markets have to be open a full day on the last trading day of the year, even though it's New Year's Eve. And so then Thursday, the markets are closed for New Year's, and just like this week, I don't think anybody's going to come back just for a Friday when they have a whole weekend. They could just extend everything and take off. So if anything, Monday and Tuesday will be our days this week to be looking to do something. Let's take a look at the intra-week action here on the futures. This is the 10-minute chart. Keep in mind, if I slide it to right here, now you've got that's the whole week right there. So Monday opened with a small gap up, 5-point range on the ES. Tuesday, another small gap up. There's just no sellers in the holiday season. Wednesday, the half day for Christmas Eve, basically closed flat. Thursday we were closed, and then Friday the gap up and closed right where we opened, left some gaps behind. If you do the same on the NASDAQ side, here's what you get. Flat opening on Monday, a little move up. Tuesday is a little more negative on the NASDAQ side. Wednesday's half day, same deal. And then Friday gap up and actually went a little higher on the Nasdaq side. And it really isn't interesting to talk about most of this because the volume was just so poor. So other than the fact that we have this holiday layout that we need to be mindful of and just aware of and pretty much just trade some small size Monday, Tuesday, what do we need to know about anything else? Well, economic data-wise, I have to use two calendars here because the Yahoo one's kind of messed up. Monday, there's no data here in the U.S. Tuesday is the S&P Housing Price Index at 9 a.m. and the Consumer Confidence Number at 10 a.m. So maybe that can get something going a little bit. Wednesday, New Year's Eve, there's a lot of data, but again, is it going to matter on New Year's Eve? Unemployment claims, that's the weekly number an hour before the bell. Chicago PMI, 15 minutes into the market. Then pending home sales, 30 minutes into the market. And then natty gas and crude oil inventories. Obviously, Thursday markets are closed, so nothing. And then Friday, 30 minutes into the market, we've got ISM index and construction spending. So I'll be here Monday and Tuesday, but of course, trading appropriately. If there's no volume in the market, there will be no point. Wednesday, we will have report calls for Monday and Tuesday. Wednesday, we will not have report calls. I may stop by early, but I don't expect much. Friday is kind of the same thing. No report calls, but I will stop by early just in case they jump in for the beginning of the year. But I just don't see it happening for one day. Everything will get back to normal the following Monday. Everybody have a great New Year's. Happy holidays from Tradesight. Charts, as usual, brought to you by eSignal.